p.m. at the Lehigh Valley International Airport, the temperature was 41 degrees under sunny skies. And in Reading, the temperature was 45 degrees under sunny skies. The National Weather Service forecast for Allentown and vicinity, this afternoon, sunny. Near steady temperature in the lower 40s.
All right, Mr. Rusty, Harp Whaler, what's going on, brother? Starting on your 980 here. I just got done tuning the weather band. And we're also going to be doing peak and tune to this. It looks to be completely stock. I know you bought it used off eBay. But this slug here looks like it hasn't been touched. And none of the coils are spread or anything like that. I plugged it in and talked through it. It's got decent audio. And to do this clarifier unlocking here, we're going to have to remove this diode here and this 0-ohm resistor there. And then we're going to have to feed 8 volts to the center pin on this plug here that goes to the clarifier. And we have to lift these two resistor through-hole resistors off the board here. I'll put some hot glue underneath them so that they don't go anywhere in case you ever do want to put it back to stock. I noticed it had a loose mic jack, so we'll tighten that up. All right, man, we'll be back. Mic gain is on 4 there. See it? A 1-2, 1-2. Yeah, the audio sounds nice. You want it clean and mean, so 100% modulated. Audio, 1-2, check, 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 check. Audio, hello, 1-2, 1-2. That looks good. 3 watts. 3 watts, audio, audio, 3 watts, and it's not even moving. And you can see, man, I'm talking right into the microphone. Bump, 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 3 watts. Let's see what your peak is. Yeah, 10 in the corner, 50 watt scale. 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, And I know you're going to want to see sideband. Let's show you RMS first. Oh. 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 Looks like a little more than three. RMS. Peak. Ugh. 10 in the corner, 50 watt scale, sideband, peak. Odie, 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 odie. Ooh, 14, 15. Oh, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Okay, so we'll be back. Bump, bump. What is that? Barking at. What's going on in there? Diva, what's going on in here? What's going on in here? What's Radar doing? Oh no. And now we got Molly coming. Where's Molly? There's Molly. Meow. All right, let's go get breakfast. Diva, please. It's time to rest. Ham and cheese omelet from Mike's. Rye toast. Strawberry grape jelly. Couple packets of ketchup. Got my cranberry juice. And then I got my salmon oil. And my hawthorn berry. Bump, bump. Thank you, Jesus, for the food. Amen. Oh, man. It's going to be a good day today. All right, that was good. Let's go back down into the dungeon. Watch your head. All right, guys, before I continue with this job, I want to showcase something here that I actually received. Sorry. I've been fighting this coronavirus for the last couple weeks. Since the common flu's not around, I guess it's the coronavirus. I received this from a really good friend of mine. This is a 1974 Panasonic AM FM cassette. Everything works. I did a complete cleanup job on it. I had the covers off. Take 6D batteries. I did have to buy a power cord for it because it didn't have one of those. But this is an RQ437S. And with some research, I found out that it's a 1974 model, made in Japan. And it still has all the original caps in it. Let me just show you how this thing works. Antenna's beautiful. No rust, beautiful chrome, nice and slick.
Behavior change.
Volume's only like a quarter of the way up. It's got a tone control too. The sound quality on this thing for one speaker is super, man. That was halfway up. But man, this is such an awesome piece, isn't it? Panasonic, 1974. The only thing that's wrong with it is the tape counter here fell out. And I got the piece, but the whole radio has to come apart. All the insides have to come out to get that tape counter back in there. So eventually I'm going to get around to doing that. This is basically going to just be a sentimental conversational piece, man. My friend Warren, like I said, he's 94 years old. He bought it when it was new in 1974. Him and his wife and family enjoyed many wonderful days on the beach with that thing and outside in the yard and painting the house and whatever they did, you know. But I'm going to keep it as a awesome memory for Warren. And I just wanted to showcase that, man. Awesome radio. Bump, bump. All right, brother, we're marrying it with this Turner Super Sidekick. And you wanted it set up for clean and mean, so that's 100% modulation. Might be a little bit meaner than clean, but that's okay. Hey, sideband's looking really good down there too. 1-2, 1-2, nice and clean. Audio 1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1. Check out the sideband RMS. That's on a 10 watt scale. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. 1-1-1-1. Oh yeah. That's 7 bird, brother. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. 7 bird sideband. That's awesome. AM. 4 watts. And these things don't really swing much, especially if they're set for clean and mean. 0-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2. 0-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2. Yeah, it puts the peak in the corner on AM. 10 watt scale, 50 watt scale peak. 0-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2. 14. Ew, audio. 14 bird peak, 15 bird peak. That's all it's gonna do, man. That's all it's gonna do, clean and mean. That's what they do. Let's show you that the clarifier is unlocked. See if I can do this with one hand. Slide up. And here's down. It's got the stock slide on the clarifier up and down. All right, let's check out the receiver sensitivity. minus 67 dBm, like always. S9. Drop her down. Down into the pits and the depths. There's 120. Wow, listen to how smooth that is. Hardly any noise. There's 130. It's loud. 130. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I still hear it at 136, man. That's amazing. And then there's 130. Blaring loud at 130. All right, let's check the sideband receive. Keep getting confused where that volume is. Upper sideband. S9. Lower sideband. S9. Bump, bump. All right, man. Bump, bump. I'll replace any 10-volt electrolytics in here, Rusty, free of charge, man. That's not a problem. I'll take care of you. All right, brother. Okay, well, that's about it for this radio. Thank you guys for coming along. I was really glad I could get to showcase that Japanese receiver that Warren gave me. That thing's awesome. This is going to be a nice little kick-ass sideband setup with this Turner Super Sidekick. These mics are like known to be one of the best, if not the best, on sideband for audio. And this radio here, it's not a powerhouse, but you saw what it was doing on sideband. It was doing 7 bird. So you get squawking in that thing, you're definitely going to be handing out some greeting cards, especially if that skip's rolling. 577 Jersey, and we'll catch you on the next one. Bump, bump. And break for radio check. Are you guys walking all over each other out there? I couldn't hear you. Is this thing working?
Your radio's working, driver.
I'm fucking up the center lane out here westbound.
Okay, I appreciate that, driver. Thank you for the comeback. Just working a little handheld here with 2 AA batteries and a paperclip antenna. Hey, have a safe trip and God bless America.
Same to you. God bless America.
Don't forget to stay 6 feet away.
You were all distorted there, driver. Bring it back.
Thank you. Brand new radio, trying to get it dialed in.
Okay, man, you sound nice and clean now, man. I don't know what you did.
Westbound at the 226.
Yeah, I'm waiting on you there in the middle.
Never a dull moment out there, right? Bump, bump. And one of these days, I gotta show you guys my signal generator here. That's the best piece of equipment that I got right there. I believe it's like a 1977 unit, vintage unit. It's in pristine condition. They actually use this thing in NASA to tune NASA radios. I had it open once. The shielding in this thing is beautiful. It's built like a tank. Maybe one of these days I'll crack it open and show you guys the inside. I never seen anything like it before. And I think brand new back in the 70s, it went for like 15,000 bucks. I got a great deal on it, but I was shopping around eBay forever trying to find a clean one that was in good working order. Actually came with the calibration certificates and everything. And the same thing with that O-scope up there. I believe that's a mid-80s. Brand new, those are like 7,000 bucks back in the 80s. So if you shop around, you can get test equipment pretty reasonable. And the frequency counters there, this Victor VC3165, you could pick that up pretty reasonable. And that's got an oven-controlled oscillator in there, and that thing's pretty damn solid. But I really do like the BK. This, the one on top is a little bit more accurate, and it's a little faster, but it takes longer to warm up. But once that top one warms up, it outperforms the one on the bottom here. The one on the bottom's accurate, but it's slow. Yeah, one of these days I'll give you guys a little tour of all this equipment and explain a little bit more in depth of what it does. And I'd love to crack open the covers on this again and show you what's inside of it. Bump, bump. Also, I'm not going to be taking in too many more radios. I'll probably be taking them in till like March 15th. And then after that, I could take them in once in a while during the summer, but the turnaround time is going to be a little bit longer. But then once December comes around, my turnaround time is about 2 weeks. Okay, guys, I just wanted to throw that out there for you. So this may be one of the last videos. I have one more here on the floor that I got to do. I believe this is for Robert. He actually dug up a TRBX4 Echo, and we're going to be putting that into this what looks like a pristine Cobra 29 Classic. So that's going to be awesome. That's going to get a peak and tune and a full VCO PLL alignment, and I'll show you some of the procedures with that PLL VCO alignment. You know, we do the complete factory service alignments. I just don't show every step. There's just not enough time to show everything on camera, so I just do what I can. But when I do this radio, I'll show you guys the VCO PLL alignment procedure. Bump, bump.